on the detail layout, when you open that record, existing record, you will be having the detail layout. Detail layout will be getting open for you, and you will be having the edit button, delete button, include offline button. Now these are the three buttons are available. Along with that, we can able to see all the associated related records also. Nothing but these are the various related records are there. Related means these are the child records. Nothing but when coming to the account, account is the parent. For that parent, we are having some multiple childs. Nothing but an account can have one or more contacts. An account can have one or more opportunities. An account can have one or more cases. An account can have some activities, the notes and attachments, and everything. So that here, all the related list will be getting displayed to you in the detail page of the record. In the detail page, you will be having the information of the record which you have entered. Suppose, for example, here. So now, whenever I'm opening the same record in the edit format, see, now, this is a record. Now, when I open the record in the edit format, we are having multiple sections are there. Account information, address information, additional information, and the description information. Multiple sections are available. In each and every section, we are having some set of fields are there. So, but when you go to that detail page of the same record, we are getting only one section that is called as account detail. So now, when coming to the customer, whenever he is trying to be entering the data, as soon as when he click on new button, now this form will be getting opened, this credit form will be getting opened where he is entering the details in each and every field. So now as soon as when he click on this save button, it will be saving the record into that associated object and it will be redirecting you to the detail page of the record. At that time, in the detail page, he will be getting only one section. So now, what happened here, when coming to the edit layout, while entering the data, I'm having multiple sections are there. Once my record has been getting saved, only one section is getting displayed. Now in that edit format, now we are having multiple sections and multiple fields are there. In the detail page, we're having only a few fields are available here. Then what is the problem? The customer may be get confused. He may be get in the ambiguity that the application may be not working properly or what. So for that here, what we have to do is, whatever the sections are visible in the edit format, the same section we have to make it visible to the detail format also, so that the look and feel should be same before creating the record, after saving the record also, so that there will not be any ambiguity. Okay, there will not be any ambiguity for the customer. You will start off the application is working fine. All the four sections are available. If you want to do any changes for those field values, then you can do those changes also. So now when coming to the account object, by default, it is going to be providing only one section inside this detail page. So now why it is not providing all those sections inside this? Now, let's see how can we customize this particular account objects layout. Now I would like to customize the account object layout here. So in order to go to that page layouts of this account object, now you can go to that setup menu. This is the standard object. It is a standard object. Now go to the setup menu. Go to the build menu in the left panel. Go to the customize, because I'm customizing the existing features given by the Salesforce as part of Salesforce CRM. Go to the customize. I would like to customize some features related to which object? Accounts. Go to that accounts inside that and expand this. I want to customize some of the features has been allocated for the account object. Now what features you want to customize? Page layouts. Now go to that page layouts section here. Okay, go to that page layouts link and then click on that page layouts link. Now click on page layouts link. Now it is providing the page layouts to you. Already we have discussed yesterday that an object can have one or more number of page layouts. Not only one, multiple page layouts also. It depends upon the user, depends upon the role. If you want to make it visible multiple page layouts, then we have to use those multiple page layouts also. So now for that, for this account object, we're having four layouts are given by the Salesforce to you by default. So now these are the four layouts are available here. Now, account marketing layout, account sales layout, account support layout, account layout. By default, Salesforce is providing one standard layout that is called as account layout. After that, Salesforce people has customized this application, and then they have created three more layouts with the name account marketing layout, account sales layout, account support layout. Nothing but for the marketing people, I want to make visible few fields. For the sales people, I want to make it visible few fields. For the support people, I want to make it visible few different set of fields. So at that time, in order to provide the different look and feels for the different people, we can able to use this page layouts also. So that here, they have created for the marketing people, the marketing layout. For the sales people, sales layout. For the support people, support layout. So now for that here, they have created multiple layouts also, and which has been given as part of the Salesforce CRM application. So now, when coming to the layouts, from these four layouts, which layout it will be using by default? Always it will be using the standard layout given by the Salesforce. Nothing but the account layout will be using by default here. So now, then how can we customize this layout here? So now when coming to the account layout, I would like to customize this. Now in order to customize that, yesterday we have discussed how to customize these options as well. Now click on edit a link. So now go to those sections. Whatever the fields that you want to place on the layout, we can able to place. Whatever the fields that you don't want, you can able to remove those fields from the layout also. Now this is the page layout is available to you. Now, when coming to my account object, in the edit section, I'm able to see all these four sections are available here. When I save this record, in the detail page, it is providing only one section to me. That is nothing but the account detail. The remaining sections are not visible to me. For that here, the user will thought of, when entering the data, so many user interface fields are there, but after entering the data, it is providing only few fields to me. So what is the problem? The application is not working properly or what else? So now for that, I want to provide the same look and feel in the edit format as well as in the detail format also. So for that, I would like to customize this layout. So now what is the problem here? So why it is not displaying this all these sections inside this? How can we enable this one? Anyone?
Question.
So now in the edit page, it is providing four sections to us. In the detail page, it is providing only one section. Then how can we enable those four sections to be get displayed in the detail page also?
Yeah, you have to go to the page. You can go to the page layout and draw like you can create a sections, and it will ask whether it is detail or edit. You have to select the detail, and you can drag and drop and create sections.
Okay. So do we need to create the sections? Just can I enable?
You must be able to copy it, right? Like, you know, because it's already exists for the edit, right?
Okay.
So can you not copy those?
Mm-hmm.
There is an option called page layout assignment. Maybe that will do this job.
Okay. But the page layout is already assigned. Already we have discussed every page layout will be having the two modes to you. One is the edit mode, second one is the detail mode. Now, while having the section, for each and every section, we have discussed about few properties. Like as in which layout, when I think about in which mode do we want to display this particular section? In edit mode?
You need to enable the checkbox, I think.
Mode. Yes, correct. Now. So now, when coming to the sections are not visible in this particular detail layout. So now further go to that page layout. Now go to the section. Already we have discussed. Now double click on that section. It is having the properties. Yesterday we have discussed here. Section name. This is the name of the section. And then display section header on where you want to display only in the detail page or in both in edit page and the detail page. So now here, I would like to make it visible in the both the layouts also. Nothing but in the detail page also, it has to display the section name. And in the edit page also, it has to display the section name in the both the section, both the layouts.
Now, why the checkbox is not enabled for edit page? It is already there, right?
Just now I have selected that here. See, when you double click on that, Now, by default, it will be enabled for the edit page. That's what in the edit page, it will be displaying that section. In the detail page, it is not displaying the section. Okay. Now, if you want to make that section has to be get displayed in the detail page also, then select this checkbox. That's it. Nothing else. No need to do anything. Now, click on OK. Now, go to the second section, address information. Double click on that section name. Now, this section is also getting displayed only in the edit page, not in the detail page. If you want to make it visible in the detail page also, then select that detail page checkbox. Now, the next section, additional information section. Double click on that. This is also displaying only in the edit page, not in the detail page. I want to make it visible on the detail page also. Select that checkbox. Now, go to that system information. I want to make it visible in the detail page also here. Now, select that checkbox. Now, description information. I want to make it visible in the detail page also. Select that checkbox. Now, we have provided all this information. If you want to customize these sections, then we can able to customize. If you want to remove any other field, then you can remove that here. The possibilities are available to you. Okay, that functionality is available to you here. Now, so now I'm making few fields are required. Like as a rating field, I want to make it required so that I'm going to be double click on the field. And then you can make that field as a required field. Now, here observe this one here. You will be having the red color symbols are there for those fields. Now, this is a mandatory field. This is also a mandatory. So this is also not, this is not a mandatory. This is a mandatory here. So now what is the difference here? So this is a blue color dot is there. For this one, blue color dot is not there. So what is the difference? What it indicates basically? Anybody has tried?
Those are the default fields. Mm-hmm.
Yesterday we have discussed one option.
Parent account is an optional field, that's why.
Okay.
Because not every account might have a parent account.
Okay. Then what exactly the blue dot symbol indicates?
Are these lookup fields?
But you cannot move them.
We cannot?
Remove them, right?
Correct, correct. Now see. So now yesterday we have discussed about an option here. I told you that when coming to this particular fields, we can able to add the fields or we can able to remove the fields from the layout also. Okay. Whatever the fields are required to make it visible, we can able to place the fields on the layout. Whatever the fields that you don't want from the layout, we can able to remove those fields also. Now, during that particular process, let's see. I'm trying to be removing this particular field here. Rating is also a standard field. Account name is also a standard field. Parent account is also a standard field. Now, whenever I'm making this rating field as a mandatory, just it will be giving a red color star symbol to me. When coming to these two fields, account name and the parent account, now these fields are having some blue color indication. So now what exactly the blue color indication here? When coming to the blue color indication, this is going to be describing this field cannot be removed from the layout. Okay. These fields compulsory should be there on the layout. We cannot remove from the layout. Now, removing from the layout means not removing from the object. Removing from the layout means just we are hiding from the display purpose. Nothing but for this set of user, this field should not be visible. That's it. Now, so now rating field. Whenever I'm trying to be removing the rating field from this layout, now we can be able to remove. Nothing but it is giving a green color indication to you. Now we can be able to remove that field. Rating field has been removed. But now whenever I'm trying to be removing this account name field, now it won't allow you to remove here. Now it is giving that red color indication that this field cannot be removed. It is giving the message, this field must be displayed on the page layout and cannot be removed. Okay. The blue color dot is going to be indicating these fields should be compulsory there on the layout. We cannot remove from the layout. This is the functionality here. Now, so now what it means here? So how can we make a field to be get cannot removed from the layout? How can we make it here? when this blue color dot symbol will be getting visible. Only for the standard fields or for my custom fields also?
I think we can click on the edit one, and you can make that not to remove, right?
Yeah. So when this particular red color, blue color mark will be getting indicated, this will be applicable for only standard fields or for my custom field?
I think both the fields you can do. You can add that, right?
How?
You click the edit on the next to minus, there is a what is that symbol called?
Okay.
Edit symbol.
So now for this one, there is no minus, nothing, but we cannot remove that.
Yeah.
But this field, there is no minus. We cannot remove this field.
Yeah.
Now I want to create a field like this, nothing, but that should be compulsory there on the layout. That cannot be removed from the layout. How can we make it?
I think you need to click on that. Click on edit, right? And then you can make as not removable.
Okay. Now, see. For example here. Let me show you that. I'm creating a new field inside my account object. Now, I'm creating a new field. In order to create a new field, you are aware of the navigation process. Go to that account subject, click on view fields, go to that custom fields and the relationships section. You can create your own new field also. I'm creating a new field inside this. Click on new button to create a new field. I'm creating a new field which is of type a text, anything. You can select any of the field type. I'm selecting the field type as a text type. Go to the next. I'm giving the field a label as some PAN number. Okay, the PAN number. I'm giving the length as some 10. Okay, I'm giving the length as 10. So now whenever you are creating the field, already we have discussed, while creating the field, we can able to make a field required. Okay, we can able to make a field required by selecting the required checkbox, by using the page layout customizations, by using the validation rules, by using the triggers. Four options are available here. So now, whenever you are making a field required, see, when you go to that layout here, now when you go to that account layout and edit format, whenever you are making a field required by using the page layout customization, like as website phone number field, I'm making required here. Now go to the properties of that field, select that required, make it save. I'm making that field required. Just now it is giving that red color indication to me. That's it. There's no blue color dot. So now, whenever you are going to be creating a new field, at the time, if you're selecting the required checkbox, okay, if you're selecting that required checkbox, now, what it means here, whenever I'm selecting the required checkbox while creating the field, then what will happen? Suppose, for example, here, assume that everybody is aware of the database concepts, the basic information. Now, I am creating a table. In the table, I want to make one column as a required in database side. How can we make a column as required? Nothing but compulsory, the user has to provide the value for that particular column. The column value cannot be null. Then what we can do?
Nullable. You cannot make it nullable. There is a, you got to, when you define the table.
Okay.
Yeah. You know, when you create the table, you have to when you define that the column, you got to say like nullable or is nullable or not.
Okay. So now for that, on the table column, we can able to add a constraint that is not null constraint.
Right.
Whenever you are adding the not null constraint, then it means nothing but on the database side also, we can able to add a check before inserting the record. It is verifying whether the user has provided the value for that column or not. If the user did not provide any value, then it won't accept that record. Compulsory, the value has to be provided by the user. So that here we can able to add a national constraint on the column. So now whenever you are going to be selecting this particular required checkbox, then on that column, nothing but when you create a field, what will happen? With this name, it is creating a column. On that column, it is going to be applying a constraint called as national constraint by default. Okay. So now whenever you are setting the required checkbox, then this required checkbox is going to be adding the national constraint on that particular column in the table database automatically by default. So now, if it is a national constraint, then compulsory user has to provide the value. So now if the user wants to provide the value, then compulsory the field should be there on the layout. Then only the user can enter some value inside that. So that here, whenever you are going to be making a field required by using the required checkbox, then at that time it is going to be marking with the blue color dot also. So that field cannot be removed from the layout because compulsory user has to provide some value in the back inside. Or else the record cannot be get inserted. So now here I'm creating that field with the required checkbox. Here I have selected that required checkbox right now. Now go to the next. Go to the next. Make it save. Now, let's go to that layouts. So now you will be having that fields, the PAN number. Now PAN number field is available, which will be displaying along with that red color star and along with the blue color indication also. This is indicating this field cannot be removing from the layout here. Why? Because is in the database side, it will be a mandatory field, nothing but compulsory we have to provide the value. To provide the value, we have to provide this control on the user interface, or else the user cannot enter the value further. If you want to make that user has to be entered the value, then compulsory this field has to be get there on the layout. That field cannot be removed from the layout here, so that it is going to be marking with that blue color indication. Because when coming to the certification point of view, these are going to be raising these kind of questions here. In the entry point of view also. How can we make that field cannot be removing from the layout? At that time, we have to create the field with the required checkbox. Then only that field cannot be removing from the layout. Compulsory, the field should be there on the layout. Then why we have to make it layout? Why we have to make it on the layout always? Because yes, as soon as whenever I'm selecting the required checkbox upon creating a new field, in that database, it will be creating a column. On that column, it is applying the national constraint. That means for that column, compulsory, the user has to provide the value. Without providing the value for that column, we cannot able to create any record. So that compulsory, the user has to provide the value for the field. So that field has to be visible on the layout. Then only they can enter some data inside. So now this is the functionalities happen between these fields. Okay, clear?
What is the Salesforce Lightning and those are we going to discuss on the fields, buttons?
Yes, we are going to be discussing about that Lightning components also.
This custom links, actor links, those.
If it is, what's going to happen if I make this PAN number as a read-only in page layout, though it's mandatory in the when we're creating the field?
See, so now whenever if you want to make it mandatory, only in the detail page that field will be getting visible to you. Read-only fields cannot be visible to you in the read layout. Only in the detail page we can be able to make it visible.
Okay.
So now we have added these sections and then we have customized this field. Whenever you are trying to be removing this PAN number field from the layout, it won't allow you to remove because here this field is a mandatory field in the database side so that in the user interface also this field should be there so that the user can enter some data inside this. We cannot remove this field from the layout. Now, the remaining fields, but whenever you are making the field required by using page layout, those fields we can able to remove from there. Yeah, tell me.
Yeah, but then this PAN number, we didn't specify where it has to be, you know, put, like which section it has to be put, right?
No, so, but in that at the time of creating the field, it will be adding in the first section at the end of the first section automatically. If you want to move it somewhere else, then we can able to move it by using the page layout customization.
Okay. All right. Got it. Okay.
So if you want to remove some of the fields, we can remove that. Whatever the field that you want to make it visible, we can make it visible. wherever you want to place the fields, you can place that field wherever you want. Okay.
Yeah.
You want to create the field and then customize the layout based on your convenience.
Okay. Okay. So the four ways you said, like, you know, how to make the field read only required is one is from the object when you are defining the field itself. Okay. One is from the page layout and then from the trigger, and there's another one also, right?
Validation rules.
Oh, validation rules you can, yeah. But the validation rules won't show any of these red
symbols
required, right? Like, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Because that's after the fact, right? After when you try to save, they will save the record or something, any of those events. Right?
Because that is one of the business strategy. Why? Because if I'm having a very big user interface, which will be having some hundreds of fields are there in the user interface, if you're making most of the fields are required with the red color checkbox, then it will be indicating that now these fields are required. Nothing but most of the fields are displaying with the red color bar symbol. Now, when the user is looking into the user interface, then he will be like as a phobia. It's like as a phobia. Like as we are having so many fields are there, so many fields are mandatory. To enter the data in those fields, it will be required more time. We need to spend more time. If the in the middle of that entering the data, the suddenly power went off, what will happen? This kind of phobias will be there, so that the people won't show interest to utilize your application. So that we have to capture the people slowly into our side. So that some fields we have to make it visible with the help of red color bar symbol. The people will start off only few fields are there which are mandatory, so that it will be taking very less time. Within fraction of seconds, we can enter the data. As soon as when they enter the data, when they click on save, validation will get fired. It will ask you to provide the data for this field also. After entering the data for that field, when they click on save, one more validation rule will get fired. It will be asking to provide the data for these fields. Like that, slowly we can able to capture the people to our side. It's one of the business strategy. So that here, whenever you are making the field required by using the page layout and by using that required checkbox, then it will be marking with the red color bar symbol. In the remaining two options, like as the trigger and the validation tools, it won't provide any red color bar symbol to you. Okay?
Yeah.
So now, when coming to the customization of that page layout, okay, we have discussed. So how can we customize that related list also here? Now go to that related list. If you want to customize the related list, then we can able to do that customization also. So now, as I have given an assignment to you to do some customization for the contact object also, for the account object. Now, so now when coming to a single account, you may be having multiple contacts, you may be having multiple opportunities, you may be having the multiple cases also. So now at that time, if I'm having the multiple contacts are available, then I would like to make the contact record to be get visible in a sorting order based on the contact name. So now in ascending order, I would like to sort those records. Or if you want to make the record to be get visible, recently created contacts, if you want to show first, then we can able to make it visible based on the created data of that field. So now for that here, it depends upon your requirement, we can able to customize. Now this is the contact related list, which will be populating all the contacts associated with this account record. Now, if you want to do any customization for this related list also, we can do that. So now what kind of customizations we can do? In yesterday's session, we have discussed. Now we can customize the related list on that page layout. We can customize the buttons on the related list. We can customize the columns to be displayed on the related list. And then we can embed the Visual Force pages also like that. So now whatever the related lists are available, we can able to customize which related list has to be get displayed, which related list should not be displayed on the layout. So now I want to show that contacts, I want to show the opportunities, I want to show the cases. Suppose if you want to show the cases first, then you can able to drag and drop wherever you want to place. Now cases should be first and then contacts and then opportunities. If you want to show the opportunities next, then you can specify cases, opportunities and the contacts like that. Open activities, I don't want activities. Activity study, I don't want. Notes and attachments, I want that. And the partners, I don't want, so that I'm removing this one. Whatever the related list that you want to be get visible on the layout, we can able to make it visible. And the remaining, we can able to remove from the layout also. Depends upon your requirement, based on the customer's expectations. Now, so now in this contacts related list, it is providing few columns to me. like as contact name, title, email, phone. I want to place two more columns also. I want to show the mobile number. I want to show the fax number also inside this table. Then how can we add this one? Now let's go to that. Go to that contacts. Click on this property symbol, which is indicating the customization, nothing but the properties of this related list. Click on these properties, or else simply you can able to double click on that related list also. Double click on that related list. It is providing the options to you. Basically, here you will be having the two options are available. One is columns, nothing but what columns that you want to make it visible on that table. And from that, based on which you want to sort the records. And the second one is the buttons, nothing but what buttons you want to make it visible. So now when you place that, when you are having that mouse pointer, you will be having the two buttons are available, new and the merge contacts. Now, so now here I want to customize this one. Double click on that. By default, it is visible, make it visible, the contact name, title, email, and the four columns to be get visible on that table. I want to show the remaining two columns also, the phone number. I want to show the fax number. I want to show the mobile number also. Select that mobile number. Now I have placed these fields also here, the phone number, mobile number, and the fax. Now in what order you want to make these columns to be get visible, you can arrange with the help of these up and down navigation buttons. And the next one. Now, if you want to sort the records, if you're having multiple contacts are there, if you want to sort those multiple contact records based on an order, then you can specify the column name. Based on which column you want to sort those records. Now, when you expand that pick list, it is providing whatever the columns that you have selected inside this, all those five column names will be getting populated to you. Based on which column you want to make it sort, I want to sort the column records based on this contact name. Now, in which order you want to sort that? Ascending order or descending order. The default order is ascending order here. If you want to make it descending, nothing but Z to A, in the reverse order, we can able to make it sort. If you want to sort the records based on A to Z format, then we can able to sort the records in ascending order. Now, these are the columns we can able to select here. Now, these settings will be applicable for which layouts here? Only for the account layout or for all the layouts here? Depends upon your requirement. Now, for all the layouts, I want to make these settings to be get visible here. And along with that, go to the buttons. When you go to the buttons, these are the standard buttons are giving by the Salesforce team. New button and the Magic Contacts button. What buttons you want to make it visible? Now, select those buttons checkboxes or else you can remove that here. If you don't want to make it visible, all these two buttons, then unselect the checkboxes. Whatever the checkboxes that you have unselected, those buttons cannot be visible to you. Now, when you click on OK, now the buttons are not visible to you here. Whatever the columns that you have added, these columns will be getting visible to you because of mobile and the fax. Now here, along with that contact name, it is giving a small indication to you. This is a sorting order, either ascending or the descending here. Depends upon your requirement. It is sorting by default as ascending order to you. Now let's save this one. Click on Yes. Now when you go to that account record, so now, as of now, you will be having all the related lists are available to you. Now refresh this user interface because we did some customizations. So now it is providing only the contacts, cases, opportunities, and the notes and attachments. Now, because we have customized this page layout where we have removed some related lists from that layout, which are not required for us, which are no need to be get visible to the customer or the user. So that whatever the unnecessary things are there, we have removed from the layout. Now, when coming to the contacts, previously we are having the two buttons are there, new contact and then merge contact. Those two buttons are also not visible to you. So now these are the contact records are available, which will be arranging the contact records based on the name. Now, along with that contact details, it is visible in that for mobile number and the fax number also. Depends upon your need, we can able to customize what fields to be get visible on that particular table or format so that we can able to see those information. So now this is a way we can able to customize that page layouts and the related list also. Clear about this feature?
Yes.
Now, so now we will see the one more options here.
Can you go to the page layout fields once? I have a question there. If you go to the editor.
Okay.
This layout properties, are we going to like discuss this layout properties? What is that layout properties at the top of the?
See. So when coming to the layout properties, now it will be giving that information account to layout.
Yeah.
So now highlights panel and the interaction log. Okay, these two features we are going to be discussing in the later sessions.
Oh, okay.
If you want to show in the console-based applications, also we can able to show in the console-based application. That will be coming under the service cloud features.
Oh, okay.
Now, the next feature is so now I would like to enable the charter feed option on the custom object detail page. How can we make it enable? Now we will see. For example, so already you are aware of the charter feed. Initially, we have discussed about the charter feed also. For example, let's open any of the account record. I have opened an account record called as Reliance Industries, which we have created in the past. Initially, we have created that account record that is called as Reliance Industries by entering some data inside that fields. Now, in each and every account records detail page, it is providing the charter feed. Nothing but the show feed option is available to you. Now, this feed option is nothing but the charter feed. So now in this charter feed, as soon as when you click on show feed, it is providing a charter feed option to you here. Okay, charter feed option is visible to you, like as a Facebook. In that Facebook, we are posting some information. That information will be getting visible to all the contacts, nothing but whatever the contacts are available inside your list. Okay, all those people can able to see your posted information. Some people will like that posting, some people will comment on that posting also. Whatever the thing which you have posted, that is called as a feed item. Okay, whatever the item, whatever the information that you have posted, that is called as a feed item. So now inside our Salesforce, it will be having one object called as feed item object. In that feed item object, it is going to be maintaining all the charter information or the charter post which you have posted inside this. Now suppose for example here, I'm posting some information like as welcome to Salesforce CRM process. Now we can able to type the information which you want to post and then click on share. As soon as when you click on share, then it will be posting that information here. Now training Salesforce user has posted some information like as welcome to Salesforce CRM process. Now, after that, if somebody wants to comment on this one, they can able to give the comment. Now they can able to comment on this one also. Like as thank you. I'm giving some thank you. Now we can able to comment on that. Okay. So now here you will be having all the information. So we have posted some information. Whatever the information that you have posted, this will be called as a feed item. All the feed items are available inside the feed item object, which is maintaining by the Salesforce by default. And then after that, you will be having that the comment information. Whatever the information that you have posted as part of the comment that will be storing inside the feed comment object. Now, when coming to the charter feed, by each and every request detail page, you will be having the charter feed is available. Okay, charter feed is available along with my object record details. Now, if you don't want to see this particular charter feed, we can able to make it hide also, so that the charter feed information has been looking like as an expand and collapsible option to us. But now, when I go to my custom object, go to the custom object positions object. Now open any of the record. Do we have the charter feed option enabled here? Charter feed is visible to you? No.
No.
Charter feed is not visible here. Then how can we enable the charter feed option on this particular layout? So now, So now by default on your custom object detail page, Salesforce will not enable user charter field. You have to enable it manually. It depends upon your requirement. Then how can we enable the charter posting field, charter field option on your custom object detail page? Now let's see. So for that, we are having some specific navigation is available. Now let's see. So now in order to enable that, we have to use a navigation process. So now go to the setup menu. Go to the build menu in the left panel. Click on customize and expand it. Click on charter and expand it. And inside that, you will be having an option called as feed tracking. Click on the feed tracking link. Select the object name. From the left panel, and select the checkbox, enable feed tracking, and click on save button. So this is a navigation in order to enable the feed tracking to be get visible on your custom objects or detail page also. By default, feed tracking will not be enabled on your custom object or detail page. In order to enable it, we have to use this navigation. You have to go to that build menu, go to that customize option and expand it. Inside that, you will be having a one more section called as the charter. And inside the charter, you will be having an option called as feed tracking. And click on that feed tracking. It will be make it visible all the objects to you available inside the Salesforce. It may be standard, it may be custom. And then select your object on which you want to make the feed tracking has to be get enabled. And then it will be providing one checkbox called as enabled feed tracking. So that we can select the checkbox and we can make it save. Now, let's go to this navigation here. Go to that setup menu. Go to the build menu in the left panel. Go to the customize and expand it. You will be having an option called as charter. Now here you will be having the option called as charter. Expand this charter option. You will be having an option called a link called as feed tracking link. Click on feed tracking. It is populating all the objects to you here. Whatever the objects are available, all the object names will be getting populated to you. Now, like as account, asset, campaign, case, like that, all the objects are available to you. Along with that, your custom objects are also visible to you inside this. My custom object is like as the position, and I'm having my custom object called as customer also here. Both. These two are the custom object we have created. Now click on your position object here. Now in the left right panel, it will be having a checkbox called as enable feed tracking. This checkbox is not selected because of that the feed option is not visible to you on the layout. If you want to make it visible, select that checkbox here. Okay, select that checkbox. So now what fields we can able to track inside this? So now I would like to select few fields. Whenever I'm going to be changing these field values, automatically these field values has to be get tracked inside. Now, the location value I would like to track, and then the maximum pay, and the maximum budget, close date, position status, I would like to track few fields information. Once you have selected that enabled feed tracking, then we click on save. Your changes has been saved successfully here. Now let's go to your position object now. Now open any of the record. Now you will be getting the feed option. Nothing but the show feed option is available to you. the chatter field. We can expand that and we can able to post some information. Whatever the information that you want, we can able to post that information also inside your custom objects or detail page also. By default, chatter posting option will not be visible to you. We have to make it visible manually on your custom objects or detail page by using that field tracking option.
But we have selected three field tracking. Why we have only one field is coming, Feroz, here? Even if I select one, it will get, right? Why do we need, I mean, we selected three. What is the significant between the field tracking and this field?
See, so now whenever you are going to be changing any of the field values here, like as some location value, whenever you are going to be changing these values, like as a position status, whenever you are going to be changing that field values, automatically it will be getting tracked. See here, that is tracking that information. Now change the location value from Bangalore to Hyderabad and the position status from new position to in progress. Nothing but what happened, whenever you are selecting that field value, if anybody has modified that field value, automatically it will be sending the notification to you that these field values have been modified by so-and-so user. Clear?
Yeah, got it.
Okay, so now nothing but keep on, it is going to be notifying those people to you here. Like suppose, for example, whenever I'm going to be using my Skype, now in my Skype application, somebody I have added for some of my friends' contacts. If any of the person has been logged in from the different location, it will be giving a notification to you, now that so-and-so person is online. If that person has been signed out, it will be giving that information, this person has been offline. Based on that, it will be changing that image symbol to you. Like that here, keep on, if you want to notify, nothing but if you want to immediately notify, if you want to track that, who has modified that information, then we can able to use this, enable that field tracking. If anybody has modified that value, then automatically, immediately, it will be sending the notification to you that this person has modified this value, so that we can able to track those informations. Whatever the fields that you have enabled, only those fields, when you modify those fields, it will be getting tracked. Suppose, for example, number of positions, I haven't selected that. If I'm changing this value 4 from 2 to 4, when you click on save, it won't track that information. Okay? Because yeah, this field is not selected here. We have selected only three fields. One is the location, position status, and the maximum budget. That's what here, that fields will be getting tracked automatically by default. Now,
who will be notified these changes, Feroz?
Immediate manager.
Everybody.
Immediate manager here.
Oh, only immediate manager?
Only immediate manager will be getting notified automatically.
Okay, if I have 10 people who are working on, like, for example, call center. If I want to notify with other users also.
Yes, so then we can able to make it the two options here. One is we can able to make it visible to the all the users, or you want to make it visible to only one user. So at that time, you will be having private and public, two options will be available to you. Okay. Whenever you are configuring that chatter posting, you will be having private and public, two options will be visible to you. So now if you're having more number of users, then it will be enabling that private and the public options. There, we can able to make it visible here. So now, in that options, we can able to make it visible here. See, show all updates. If you want to show all updates, then we can able to specify. So now, if you want to update only few things, then you can able to specify here. Now, so now for that, if you want to make it visible to all the people, then we can make it as public. If anybody has modified, then everybody can able to get that notification that this person has modified these field values here. Now, whatever the chatter posting that you have made, okay, whatever the chatter posting that you have made, every week Salesforce is going to be sending that the daily digest. Nothing but for every week, you will be receiving a notification from the Salesforce side that these are the various chatter posting options that you have enabled and that you have posted information that will be sending to your email ID automatically. You will be getting, like as the weekly magazines we are receiving, in that you will be getting some information. Like the same way, in this particular week, what are all the records on which we have posted some information, chat and information which you have posted, everything will be getting consolidated that will be sending to you or email ID automatically by Salesforce every week. So that we can able to get that notification, chatter postings information also. Now, the next feature. Now, the next feature is we are going to be customizing the standard object tabs and the field labels. So now, sometimes they will be raising some question here. For example, I have this account object. Now, account means what? My customer. Now, my client asked me here, I don't want to show that object tab name as accounts. I want to show it like as customers. I want to show like as my customers or whatever. Or I want to show like as resources. Now, after that, inside that account, you will be having some columns are available, fields are available to you. Account name, parent account number, account site, like that some fields are available to you here. So now I don't want to show these names like as rating phone. I want to display with the different name, like as customer rating. Now contact number, instead of phone, I want to show contact number. No, instead of simply fax, I want to show fax number. And then for that account name, I want to show like as customer name. Then how can we change this one? These are the standard fields. Okay, these are the standard fields. If it is my custom field, then how can we change? If it is a standard field, then how can we change? Now, let me show you this one. Now, suppose for example, I'm having the position object. In this position object, I'm having few fields are available here. Like as it is giving the name, like as position name and the number of positions and the recruiter's email ID, everything is available. Location is everything is available. Position status, all these fields are there. I want to customize these fields here. Now these names I want to change. Now let's go to your object. Go to the fields. You will be having the standard fields. You will be having the custom fields are available. If you want to change the name, then simply click on that edit link. Simply click on edit link. We can able to modify that. Now this is displaying like as a position name. I would like to display like as open position or the new position. New position name. Make it save. So now instead of displaying like as a normal position name, I have changed this label as new position name so that this position label will be getting displayed like as new position name. We can able to modify that label also here. Now, if you want to change that positions tab information, then what we can do, we can go to the tabs, we can able to change that names also here. That possibility will be available to you. Now, you can go to the edit button and then the tab plural name is positions we have given. I'm giving that like as my positions. Click on save. Now your tab name has been changed to my positions. Nothing but what happened, if it is a custom object, we can able to change the label, we can able to change the tab name in feature very easily. Just we can go to that object and we can able to click on the edit button and we can able to change the label based on your need. But if it is a standard, then how can we customize? How to customize this standard here? Suppose for example, I want to change the label of my account object. Instead of showing this like as accounts, I want to show my customers. Because account means a customer. Then how can we display like as my customers? Now, how can we change this label? Now, let's go to your object. You will be having that option called as view object. But we don't have any such option to modify that. Then how can we change that labels here? For example, I want to change the labels of that fields. Instead of displaying like as account name, I want to show customer name. Now this field value, I want to change it like as the customer name. Then how can we change? Now, when you go to that fields, click on view field. Field name is available here, account name is available, but there is no option in order to modify that. When coming to the rating here, I want to change the rating field. When you click on edit button, now it is not giving that option to me to change that label here. Nothing but this is in the read-only format. Then how can we change these labels of these standard fields given by Salesforce to us? Now, so now for that, we have to use a different navigation, customizing that the standard fields and the standard object tabs. Now, by default, Salesforce will not allow to change the tab names and the field labels of the standard objects. We can customize the tab names and the field labels as below. For that, you will be having a separate navigation to customize this one. So that, go to the setup menu and click on it. Go to the build menu in the left panel. Click on customize and expand that. Click on rename tabs and labels. Rename tabs and labels link. So now as soon as when you click on rename tabs and labels link, then it will be asking you to provide that names here. Now let's go to this navigation here. Now let's go to the setup menu. Go to the build menu in the left panel. Click on customize. Inside that customize, you will be having the tab names and the labels. Expand this, you will be having a link called as rename tabs and labels. Now just click on this rename tabs and labels. Now it is providing all the object tabs which are designed by the Salesforce for the standard objects. Now these are all are the standard objects given by the Salesforce for those objects. Whatever the tabs has been assigned, these tabs will be getting visible to you. Now accounts, activities, articles, assets, campaigns, cases, coaching, contracts, and then everything is available to you here. All the standard objects and the tabs are available to you. For the custom objects also, you will be having the tab names and the custom object tabs are also available. Custom object tabs directly we can modify by using that the view object, click on edit button, we can change it. But if it is a standard object, we have to go with this navigation. Go to the customize, click on tab names and the labels, and then click on rename tabs and labels option. Now, so now which tab name that you want to change? I want to change this accounts tab name as my customers. Okay, I want to change it as my customers. Now, so for that here, go to that accounts tab. This is accounts tab is available here. This is the account information. Now accounts. So now I would like to change this one. Click on the edit link in order to modify the settings of the tab name or the object field labels. Now click on edit. Now it is providing that information to you. Like the singular label is nothing but the account and the plural label name is accounts. Instead of accounts, I'm changing it as my customers. I'm giving the name as my customers. Now here you will be having two options are there. Save button, next button. So what is this save button? What is this next button? Sometimes I want to change only the label name of the tab. That's it. I don't want to change any field names inside that object. Sometimes if you want to change the label of that tab along with that object for field labels also. Not only the tab name, I want to change the labels of the fields inside the account object also. At that time, go with that next button. If you want to change the label names of those fields also, click on go to the next button. All the fields will be getting visible. This is the field and this is a singular label, nothing but the field name. So now here you will be having so many fields are available which we can able to show over here. Now, for this rating, I want to give the field a label as customer rating. You can just change that label whatever you want. Previously, this is simply rating. Now I want to show it like as the customer rating over here. Now for the phone, it is displaying like as a phone. I don't want to display the phone here. I want to display like as contact number. Contact number. Now for this account name, for the name field, it is providing the account name. Now, so now you will be having that account name. HDAF account name, I'm using that customer name. Customer name. And then you will be having the fax. For that fax, I'm giving that fax number. Industry. I'm giving that customer industry. Like that, we can able to change that field labels which you want, depends upon your requirement. Now for the standard object fields also, we can able to make it change. Now, save. Once you are done with all the changes, then click on save. Now we have changed the labels. Now when you observe the tab name will be getting visible like as my customers. Instead of accounts, it will be displaying like as my customers. Now, when you open that account tab, it will be providing the new button to create a new account record. Click on new button, it is providing that field names also. Like as customer name, instead of account name, it will be displaying like as customer name. Instead of rating, simply it is displaying like as customer rating, the contact number, fax number. Like that, we can able to change those values.
Firoz, I have a question. Like, if you are changing this tab names, is it going to be for this application or entire application in the org?
See, in, for the entire application in the organization.
But I want to have like the custom object should be in one or one app should be by default, and another one I want my own. Can I do that or not?
Default means what?
Whatever, if I am in a sales app, I should be account. If I am in a marketing one, it should be my customer.
Okay, you want to make it like as a different. For depends upon the application, yes. You want to make the tab to make it different.
Yes.
So, but that is not possible here. Okay, because we are using that same object, but we are going to be using in the multiple applications inside this. So that whatever the settings that we have applied, the same settings will be getting visible. At that time, if you want to make it differentiated, then we can go with that customization. By using VisualForce, we can able to define the tabs, and based on that, we can able to change the label according to the application. The possibility will be available to us. Okay?
We can do based on the application, so we have to do
application. We can customize that label also by using VisualForce.
Okay.
Now here, not only changing the labels of the or the tab names of the custom object, we can able to change the label names, and we can able to change the tab names of the standard objects also. That possibility is available to you in Salesforce. That much of customizations are available inside this. Okay. Now, the next feature. The next feature is, how can we track the field history? So what exactly the field history tracking? I think already we have discussed during the creation of the objects. So what is the field history tracking?
Want to see what the value change from, like, for example, A to B, B to C. If we are like each time the value get changed, it will be tracked.
Okay.
For the audit purpose.
Yes. For the audit logging purpose, I would like to track the fields information. Like for example here, I'm having a record, like a stake one position record. Now I'm having a position record called as Oracle developer. Now as a recruiter, I assume that I am a recruiter. I'm working on this position recruitment process. In order to close that position, we are having few more dates are available here. Okay, few more time is available. So now let's assume that we are having the time till the November 10th. Now I'm selecting that as November 10th. So now here we are having some more time to close this position right now. So now still I'm working on this position record here. Now yesterday also I have observed that position record, the status says in progress. But today morning, when you observe the position record status has been changed to closed. Somebody has changed the position status to closed. Then I got shocked. Now I'm recruiting the candidate for the position, but this position status has been changed to closed. Who has changed this position status to closed? Why they have changed? When they have changed? Which person has changed this position status has been to closed? I would like to track this information. Because here, I would like to know who has modified that particular field values. I would like to track those history information. When they have modified, why they have modified, at what time they have modified, and what is the old value, what is the new value. Everything I would like to track inside this. Then how can we track the field history here? Okay, now we will see practically. So now whenever if somebody has modified that record, because in my organization, not only myself, so many other people are also working. So many other customers are also there. So many other salespeople are also there. So many other support people are also there. Everybody is available here. Now we are all are sharing this object. We are all are sharing this workload in order to complete this task. So that here, if anybody has modified that field value, then I would like to track who has modified, when they have modified, why they have modified, what is the old value, what is the new value, everything I would like to track. In order to track that history of a particular field, we are having a feature called as field history tracking. Okay, we are having the feature called as field history tracking. So now by using this field history tracking, we can able to track the history of the field. Now, as of now, how many people has modified this field value here? When they have modified, what is the old value, new value, everything we can able to track. Then how can we enable this field history tracking? Now we'll see. So now whenever if you want to enable the field history tracking, first of all, while creating that object, we have to select the checkbox called as enable history tracking checkbox. Now, in order to track the field history of an object, in order to track the field history of an object, we have to enable the field history tracking. We have to enable the field history tracking upon creating an object. Upon creating the object. Upon creating that object, we have to select that checkbox here. Nothing but we have to select the checkbox, then only we can able to track the field history. If that field history tracking checkbox is not selected, then we cannot able to add that. We cannot able to track the field history of those fields. Now, that is, we have to select the checkbox. Field history tracking from optional section. From the optional section of that object creation, we have to select the checkbox field history tracking. Then only we can able to enable the field history tracking on that. Then how can we track the field history? Now we'll see practically here. Let's see. For example here, when coming to my position object, I'm having few important fields are there. Like, I have few important fields, the location field, position status field, and then the close date field, and the maximum budget. Now assume that these are the four key fields are available inside this. Because for the position location also, we cannot change every time. We have to give a standard location. So now suppose, for example, initially they have given the location as Hyderabad. Once we have recruited the candidates from changing the status location from Hyderabad to Bangalore, then the candidate may not be interested to relocate. For that here, these field values cannot be get changed. So now, if anybody has modified that field value, I would like to track. I would like to get that notification. So now, the status also here, this is key, playing very key role for my task. Based on the status only, I can able to keep on working on this task. If the position status has been closed, then no need to work on this position, no more time. And the close date also. This close date is also very crucial for me because based on this close date, we need to recruit the candidate for the position. Maximum budget. As per our company policy, we are having some bandwidth, we are having some bands. Now for this much of years of experience, I can able to offer this much of packages. For the fresher, this is a fixed package. For 2 to 3 years of experienced people, this is the package. For 4 years experience, this is the package. We are having some fixed bands are there in my company policy. Based standard, we have offered this maximum budget. If I need to offer more than this budget, then I need some approval from my higher level managers also. So now for that, here, if somebody has modified this maximum budget value, then I need to track that information. Now assume that these are the four fields are which are very important for my record so that if anybody has modified that field value, then I would like to get the tracking information of that. Who has modified, when they have modified, what is the old value, what is the new value, I would like to track inside this. Then how can we track this information here in our Salesforce? Let's see. In order to track the field history, we have to go to that a button called as field tracking history button. So where it is available here. Now we have to go to your fields, go to the first StratCon quick access menu, click on view fields, go to that custom fields and the relationships section. In that custom fields and relationships section, you will be having a button called as set history tracking. Okay, set history tracking. Now this is the button is available here. When this button will be getting visible to you, while creating the object, if you're selecting the checkbox enable field history tracking, then only this button will be getting visible to you. Now, let me show you practically here. Suppose, for example, I'm modifying my object information. Go to your position object, click on edit button. You will be having the four checkboxes are available inside that optional features section. Allow reports, allow activities, track field history. If I'm not selecting the checkbox, then observe what will happen. I have unselected this checkbox, track field history here. Now, let's save this one. When you save this, then the settings has been modified. Let's go to your custom fields and relationships section. Here, you will not be getting that button, nothing but at the time of creating an object, if you did not select the checkbox field history tracking, then set history tracking button will not be visible to you. So now, in order to make this button to be get enabled, the first option is, the prerequisite option is, we have to select the checkbox enable field history tracking. Now, so now for that, go to this object, click on edit button. Yeah.
Yeah, is it only for custom, fields or like it's for standard fields?
Standard fields also, for everything.
It is not seen over there, so I just thought near the standard fields.
Standard fields means where?
Like you just showed one standard field.
Okay.
Right here, okay.
See?
Yeah,
standard. So now fields, we so. Don't have two separate buttons for the standard fields and the custom fields. Okay, it will be providing the button only one place to you. Nothing but this is the customized option. If you want, you can enable. If you don't want, you can able to disable that. So for that button will be only one.
Okay, but it is.
It will be applicable for both standard and custom fields both.
Okay.
Now let me show you that practically to you. Now, go to that edit button of that object. Select that checkbox, track field history. I have selected that checkbox track field history. Now make it save. Now, as soon as when you save that, it will be enabling the button called as set history tracking. Now, in order to track the history of those fields, click on this button. When you click on this button, it will be asking you which fields information you would like to track. All the fields information or only few important fields information you would like to track. I don't want to track all the fields information. I would like to track only a few important fields information which are playing very key role inside my application. Suppose, for example, if I'm having a loan application form. As a bank manager, I have to decide whether I can able to approve the loan or I can reject that loan. So at that time, what happened? I got a loan application from one of the customer. He has applied for a personal loan. Now, as a bank manager, I have to go through the various considerations before approving that particular loan, like as his customer's account, since how long time he is our customer, how efficiently he is using his transactions, whether he is having any pre-existing loans or not. If he is having the loan, then how is the payments here, payment details? What is his CIBIL score, his credibility, everything I would like to cross check. I would like to take all these things as the considerations before approving the loan. So now if his CIBIL score is less than some 700 or 600, I would like to reject his loan. So for that here, I'm going to be changing the loan application status as rejected. But one of my colleague inside my bank, he has modified that status to approved. So yesterday as a bank manager, I have rejected that, but somebody has changed the status to approved. Then who has changed the status? Because that loan application status will be playing a very major role for me. So because in future, if somebody asks me, then this person's credibility is not good, CIBIL score is also very, very less, then he haven't paid that amount on time for the pre-existing loan, then how you have approved that? Then I have to give some explanation. So for that here, I need a tracking mechanism who has approved that loan. So for that here, I'm going to be enabling this particular field history tracking only for some important fields, not for other fields. Now, select that fields on which you would like to add a tracking. Nothing but I would like to make an eye on that so that if anybody has modified, I can able to track that information. Click on set history tracking. Now it is providing that fields to you. Okay. Now it is providing that fields to you. In that fields, you will be having owner field, nothing but your standard field. Position name, this is also standard field. Nothing but this is not only for the custom fields which we have created, this will be applicable for both standard fields and the custom fields information also. We can track the history of both standard fields as well as custom fields also. Now you will be having that information. Now, what fields information you would like to track here? I would like to track the information of my positions, the status field, and then I would like to track the information of maximum budget, close date, and the location field, and the number of positions also, and my position name also here. So now, these are the various fields which I would like to track the information. So now, close date field, maximum budget, new position name, location field, number of positions field, position status field. These six fields information I would like to track because these are very crucial for me to take some more decisions on this position record. So that here, I would like to track the history of these fields. Nothing but in future, if anybody has modified this particular field values, if anybody has changed these field values, then I would like to track that history. Nothing but who has modified that field value. When they have modified everything, I would like to track on that. So now select the fields which you would like to track. Whenever you are going to be tracking the field history, we can able to track maximum of 20 fields history, not more than that. Salesforce has some governor limit that we can able to track the history of maximum of 20 fields per an object. Okay, not more than 20 fields per an object. Okay, this is the limitation. Because the limitations, why I'm stressing out is limitations are very, very important in the certification point of view. In certification, mainly they're concentrating on the governor limits. What are the limitations are there? Okay. So now for that. So now you will be having the fields are available from those we can able to select maximum of 20 fields on that. Now let me show you that fields information here. When you go to your fields, you will be having a column here. Okay, track history column. Now these are the fields are available. It may be standard, it may be custom. You will be having a column called as track history, nothing but whether you are tracking the history of these fields or not, which will be indicated by this checkbox to you column. Checkbox column will be indicating to you. Now this is the checkbox column is available. Now, so now this checkbox selected means nothing but we have enabled the history of this particular field so that we can able to track that information. Now for the custom fields also, you will be having that history tracking. Now this is the column is available, history tracking is track history. Now checkboxes are there. Now whatever the field that you have selected to track the history, then click on save, automatically these fields will be getting enabled here. Now when you go to that fields, for that standard fields, I am going to be tracking the history of that name. If anybody has modified in future, then I would like to track the history of that information. Now the close date field also, location field also, maximum budget field also, number of position field also, and then position status also. These are the six fields that I have selected, which I would like to track in my future. If anybody has modified this field values in future, then I would like to track who has modified, when they have modified, what is the old value, what is the new value here. Now, we have enabled the history tracking on these particular six fields now. Then how can we see that information? Suppose, for example, here, let's go to any of your object record here, inside your object. So now we are having some fields are there. Now, for example, I'm changing that close date value at the maximum budget. Maximum budget, I'm having some 20 lakhs are there. Now I'm changing it to 30 lakhs. Now I have saved this value here. So now where I can see this information, who has modified, when they have modified, what is the old value, what is the new value, then how can you track this information? So now for that, in order to store the history of each and every object, Salesforce is going to be maintaining one related list called as history. Now it is maintaining a related list is available here. If it is an account object, you will be having a separate related list. Object name and the related list. For each and every object, Salesforce is providing one related list to you, which we need to add onto your layout. For that account object, you will be having a related list called as account history. For the contact, you will be having a related list called as contact history. For the opportunity object, you will be having a related list called as opportunity history. For the case, you will be having a related list called as case history. And for the lead object, you will be having a related list called as lead history. Like that, for each and every standard object, you will be having the related list. Then what about my custom object? So now we have created a custom object called as position object. Will Salesforce will provide any related list? Yes. Salesforce is providing the related list for your custom object also. For that, you will be having position history. For your customer object, which is also a custom object we have created, customer history. So now it is providing the history related list to you for each and every object by default. So now in this history related list, we can able to track each and every information. So now this is a related list here. Related list is not visible to you on that page layout. Then how can we add the related list on the layout? You are aware of that. In the previous session, we have discussed about the page layout customization. Go to that object's page layout. Go to that object. Go to the page layout of that object now. This is the page layout of my position object, that is position layout. Click on that edit link. Now you will be having only one related list, that is called as notes and attachments. I want to add one more related list also. For that, go to that left panel inside this edit. Now go to that related list. Click on that related list link in the left panel. It is providing all the related list which can be added onto that page layout. Now inside that, you will be having a related list called as position history. Okay, position history. Now this position history related list, we can able to place onto your layout, wherever you want. Depends upon your requirement. Now make it save. Yes. So now, when you go to that layout, we have modified, customized this layout just now by adding that related list on that. Now go to your app record, refresh the record right now. You will be having the tracking information. Now the position history. when you have created on 29th, 10th, nothing but last month 29th, I have created the record here. This is the created. Now today, nothing but 111 at 6:14 p.m., we have changed that maximum budget value from 20 lakhs to 30 lakhs. Now, I'm changing some more field values here. I'm changing the location value from Hyderabad to some Delhi. Position status some close to some in progress. And then I'm changing the number of position values from 4 to some 2. I'm changing the close date value from 11 to some 10 to the 15, sorry, 14. Now, save this one. Now we have modified four values here. All these things will be getting tracked over here. Now we have four. Now at 6:18 p.m., I have, this is the user has modified. What values he has changed? The close date value from 10:11 to 14:11. Position status value from close to in progress. Number of positions from 4 to 2. Location value from Hyderabad to Delhi. Like that, everything we can able to track inside that. Whenever if anybody has modified that field value, they can able to track that information. That possibility is available in Salesforce, where we can able to enable that field history tracking, by which we can able to track each and every field's information if anybody has modified. So now this is the way we can able to track the field history. If you want to track the field history, the prerequisite thing is, first of all, upon creating that particular object, we have to enable that field history tracking. Then only we can able to track that. Once you have enabled that, then we have to select the fields which information you would like to track. Once you have selected the field, the third step is we have to add that associated related list onto your page layout. So that here, these are the three steps that we need to perform here. Okay, the first step.
Firoz.
Yeah.
Actually, how long this history will remain? Like, you know, if it is an object, is a very old object, and you know, you keep changing the values. So, I mean, how long that history will remain in that page?
So in that history, we can able to store the last 18 months data. Last 18 months, nothing but 1.5 years, the tracking history we can able to maintain inside that.
Okay.
Now, clear?